This week on Maker Update, a mechanical tulip, the E3D print slicer, a Lego walkie-talkie twitch switch, 3D printing with DiResta, a triaxial clock, Laura Kampf swing bike, and turning pixels to G-code. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome to another Maker Update. I hope you're all doing well and having an awesome week. I have been spending much of the week cleaning out my garage and trying to get a better system of organization in there. It's been rough, but I'm optimistic. I also want to remind you guys that next week's going to be the Adafruit edition of Maker Update over on the Adafruit channel, so don't miss that. And now, let's get started with the project of the week. Check out this mechanical LED tulip on Instructables by jiripraus. The project uses brass rod, surface mount NeoPixels at the center, even smaller surface mount white LEDs across the pedals, a touch sensor, a tiny servo, and an Arduino Nano tucked into a wooden base. Aside from being a beautiful and unique design, what really puts this project over the top is the incredible documentation. Jiri includes detailed photos, videos, diagrams, and animations of how it all goes together. He's got some good tips on freeform circuits, creating movement with push rods, soldering brass, and using templates to create multiple consistent pieces. It's an intricate and advanced project to take on, but the payoff is this delicate, one-of-a-kind work of art. It's time for some news. There's a new 3D model slicer out called Pathio. It's available as a free beta for Windows, Linux, and Mac. At first glance, it seems like it's targeting advanced users looking for better resolution, custom scripting options, and the ability to create G-code files where different elements can be grouped for different print settings. If it sounds like something you'd be into, go check it out. More projects. Bob Claggett from I Like to Make Stuff made this wireless hotkey controller shaped like a Lego walkie-talkie. The heart of the project is an Adafruit Bluefruit board acting as a Bluetooth HID keyboard. Bob wires up three buttons to the board, which he defines in the code as the hotkeys he needs for Twitch video stream control. The project is also a clever use of embedded magnets to add a removable cover. This way he can easily access the board and recharge the batteries when he needs to. Bob's friend Jimmy DiResta has a surprising project up on his YouTube channel. Using a 3D printed model, he shows how to cast a metal belt buckle. He makes one out of melted brass bullet casings, empty ones, and another from melted aluminum computer parts. On Thingiverse, Steve McGowan has this gorgeous design for a three-axis 3D printed Tourbillon clock. The design features over 50 parts, some of which need to be attached with screws and ball bearings that are listed in the included build materials. If you're into clocks or gears or just beautiful, challenging projects, put this one on your to-do list. You also have to check out Laura Kampf's video on how she made this nearly unrideable swing bike. By chopping out the steering section from a scrap bike, she's able to add a hinge to a bike frame that allows the front and back wheel to swing out of alignment. It's a crazy build and it makes anyone riding it look drunk, but it's a great video to see all the techniques Laura uses for chopping and welding the bikes together. I found some useful tips and tools this week. First, the Cool Tools podcast has a great episode up with experienced designer Tommy Honton. He's a maker worth knowing about and he has some useful tips to share. David Picciuto from Make Something has a great video up on getting started with screen printing, how it works, and what you need. It's a fun process to understand and fun to watch, even if you don't think it's something for you. Similarly, on Applied Science, Ben Krasno runs through his setup for high-resolution screen printing with more of an emphasis on printing with epoxy paints that will stick to metal, glass, and circuit boards. For another take on old-school printing, on Hackster, Jeremy S. Cook pointed me to this project by Matthew Rayfield that turns any 3D printer into a dot matrix printer. The secret sauce is a web app that Matthew created that turns any image file into a dithered dot matrix G-code file that you can send straight to your printer. You'll have to find a way to attach a pen to your printhead, but even rubber bands seem to work. What's especially cool is that the web app includes an option to create multicolor prints where you can select colors from the original image to separate out, and the G-code will include a pause statement that will allow you to swap out the pen color. So cool. One practical little project I printed out this week is this packing tape dispenser by Aiden Rose. I'm sure there are a bunch of designs like this out there, but I liked how this one includes a nice wide spot to hold the end of the tape, and this unique cutout here that lets you come at it with a pair of scissors. The Ruiz brothers have a new Fusion 360 tutorial on how to take circuit board designs and animate them to spin around using the joints feature. And one of my favorite tips this week is this one from Mohit Boyt, showing how to straighten and stiffen brass wire by slowly twisting it in a drill chuck. As Mohit points out, this technique isn't new, and he links to a video by JohnnyQ90 where he learned about it. I tried it this week with steel wire, and it works really well. Definitely give it a try. Finally, on the Cool Tools channel, I've got a video up comparing four different brands of gaffer tape. It's an 8-minute gaffer tape geek out, but the takeaway is that there's a distinct difference between some brands. Maker Faires! This weekend, we have Lille, France, Lafayette, Indiana, St. Joseph, Missouri, and Cairo in Egypt. If one's near you, go check it out. Also, the second Plotter People meetup has been announced. It takes place March 13th at GitHub headquarters in San Francisco. I went to the first one, and it was a lot of fun. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, or leave a comment. Remember that next week's show is going to be the Adafruit edition of the show that I do once a month over on the Adafruit channel, so you can go check it out over there. Better yet, you can keep up with the show by subscribing to the email newsletter that I put out every week, which includes show notes and links. And a huge thanks to my Patreon patrons. Couldn't do it without you. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next week.